Subscribe Technical Babaji channel and press the bell icon to get the latest video updates.
So these are the coding which I have done in the last video. If you haven't watched that video, please click on the I button and you can watch that. Okay. So now in this video, I'm going to integrate Winston logger so that I can take the log into console, file or into MongoDB database. The first thing which I'm going to do here is I'm going to create one more file inside the config folder, logger.js. Now I need Winston package. Okay. So see, this is the official npm documentation for the Winston. Here you can see the download per week. It is downloading more than 3 million people downloading this package per week. So this is the most powerful and popular logging package. Okay, so you can install this. Now just click over here to copy this. Control V. So Winston package installed successfully. Now let me configure here const require Winston package. I need three things from Winston package, which is create logger, then transports, then format. Save it. Then now let me create logger object, create. Now I have to define the transport. So what is the transport? So transport will carry your data from your applications to either in console, file or MongoDB, wherever we define. Okay. Now it will be in the array, so we can define multiple transports. New transports, then dot. First thing, I'm going to show you how you can console the log. Okay, inside this you can define the level. So level, we have the different level in Winston. You can read out in the documentations like info, error, silly. Here I'm defining the level info. My console transporter is ready, so just let me show you that. If I'll apply this, so before applying this, we have to export this so that we can import in other files. So module.exports logger. That's it. So just come back over here, and in place of console, I'm going to use control V logger.info, either info, or if you don't want in this format, then you can use dot log and define inside this info first parameter. In this way also it will work. Now just npm start, and here you can see level info is coming and message server up and running on port. So better you can do this control X. It will not work like this. So what I'll do here, backtick, I'll use backtick. And control V. Okay, now save it, and you can see running on port number 3000. Okay, fine. Now I need one more thing, timestamp. Timestamp is not there, so log with timestamp. So what I'll do here, I'll just format it. So inside this format dot combine, inside this format dot timestamp, and format dot json. Now just see. Okay, sorry, control S. Now here you can see it's coming with timestamp also, label, message and timestamp in this format. Now if you don't want in this way, if you want in a simple format, you can just replace this with simple. Now just see, my log is coming plain text format. Now if you want to more format, you can do more. There is more customization options in, but normally we need JSON if you want to store in MongoDB database. Now I'll show you how you can log this into the file, the second step. So you just have to change in place of console, you can do the file, and you can define the file name colon, like I'm giving info.log. okay, file name comma put here, and just save this. Now you can't see here log, But if you go inside info.log, you can see here. So let me delete this info.log file so you can understand again. Okay, now just let me save this again. Now here you can see info.log and my data is coming here. Okay, the third thing, if you want, you want to take the log into the MongoDB database, then we need one more transporter. So if you go into the table of content, here you can see transporter. Just click over here. So Winston transporter. So inside this you can see this core transports and additional transports. So here you can see with Winston, these are the built-in transporters coming with, and these are maintained by Winston contributors. So MongoDB transporter. So you have to install additional package. Okay, this is not coming with Winston. Okay, so this is the package name. You just have to do Control C. Let me open one more terminal, and here you can write npm I and paste that. Okay, winston-mongodb. Now once this is installed, another thing, we need MongoDB. But I'll recommend you don't download MongoDB in your local system because it is too heavy, so it will slow down your system. Instead of that, you can go to the official website of MongoDB, www.mongodb.com/cloud, and here you can try free. So it will give you the cloud MongoDB for free. Now let me show you, I'm using that. Then you can sign up and you can create your one cluster with your username and password. So it will look like this. If you want to connect with your applications, you just have to click on connect. It will show you the three way, but we are interested in connect your application, not with cell and not this one. Okay, so just click on this. It will give you one string here, and inside this string you can see this one. So this is your username and this is your password, will be your password. So you have to remove this and write here your password which you have selected at the time of creating this cluster. So just copy this string. So go back to your coding, and first thing, I'm going to add that string inside my environment variable MongoDB, and this is the string, and I'm not going to show you my password here. I'm replacing that with my own password. Okay, and then save this. That's it. Package I have already installed. So now we can import this. So what I have to do, just go to the logger.js, import that package, require. Okay, now let me create multiple transporter. It's new transporters.mongo and define this method. So error is coming, just put comma here. The first thing, the first parameter db. So inside this you can pass your url, the url which I have stored in environment variable. We can access through MongoDB comma URL. I have written like this or not, let me check. Okay, only MongoDB I have written here. Okay, come back here, paste here MongoDB. Now we can define the level here, level. So I'm defining the level error, so only in case of error I'll log this into the MongoDB. Now we can define one more thing, collection name. If you don't define, then by default it will take log. So here I'm defining the collection name Babaji. Okay, so inside the Babaji collections, you'll see all the document of log. Now just save this and see. So MongoDB is connected, but you can see one deprecation warning. Okay, we will solve this deprecation warning later on. As of now, we are just going to see this is logging in MongoDB database or not. So what I'll do here, in place of info, I'm going to log error. I'm giving just error. You can also do dot error. Okay, this is the another way. Now I haven't formatted this one, so let me format before logging into the database. So I'm going to this format, just let me copy paste, Control C, Control V, then save it. Now just go into your MongoDB and check that log is coming or not. So just click on collections. Here you can see automatically Babaji collection is created. Now here you can see the log. Okay, so you can see timestamp is coming, level error is coming, message is coming. So in this way you can log into the MongoDB. Now let me solve this error, why this is coming. So what we have to do is here, just inside the MongoDB transporter, use one more options. Whatever you see in the console, just copy this, Control C and paste here. Put comma at the end. Now save this, you will not see any deprecation warning. Okay, fine. Now if you'll go inside the MongoDB database, refresh your database, and you can see the second log also coming here. So thank you guys for watching this video. In the next video, I will show you how to intercept request and response objects so we can log each request is coming in our application and each response is going from my application. So we log each and everything in some format so we can retrieve the informations later on in future. Okay. In this video, that's it. Thank you.